Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. We're talking about lip filler and the 8 reasons to get lip filler. So there are some good reasons that patients present to the clinics to get lip filler, and some aren't good reasons. Here are 8 great ones. The first one is just that people like the look, and it's okay. It exists today. We have good products that are safe, that last a long period of time, that you can get dissolved, and it's in fashion, it's in trend, and no apology necessary. People have a good option to get them. It's obtainable by many people, and they choose to do it. So it's look, it's confidence. They need to put less makeup on. They feel like the face is lifted, and you watch our 3D images of before and after lips. That comes through. Number 2, a gummy smile. So when people have a full smile, some teeth should show. That's kind of the way it should look, even though there's no specific right or wrong. That's what people look for. And if people have a gummy smile, there's things you can do with neuromodulators to help keep it low. But adding lip filler a lot of times, as long as it's not an extreme gummy smile, in which case we would add neuromodulator to it, the lip filler really helps. And what you see is people smile more. And when they smile more, they're more successful, they get more of what they want, they have more confidence, and it changes their life. So a gummy smile is one good reason. And number 3, lip projection. So if you see someone in their youth, let's say early 20s, you'll notice a crisp vermilion border where the red meets the white of the lip, and a nice forward projection. And that looks youthful. As we age, that changes. And as we flatten, then what happens is we look a little bit older and we don't have that youthful projection. So adding that vermilion border is a great reason to get lip filler. Number 4, the ergotrid. So as we age, the bone in the maxilla, it kind of involutes. And so as that happens, the mouth does that and you get a longer ergotrid. The distance from the nose to the top of the lip lengthens. So to shorten that distance and get you back towards 5, if you want to use 1.61 to 1, or just to your eye, we can calculate 5 or what we think is attractive. You don't even need to measure it. We can shorten the distance. It looks more youthful, more attractive, and creates a better angle. Number 5 is the vermilion border. Yes, we get projection with the vermilion border, but the other reason is vertical lip lines are very aging. And people with skin types 1 to 3, lighter colored skin with sun damage or genetically, they'll flash vertical lip lines even as early as their mid to late 20s. And then when you see them in their 30s, 40s, 50s, the vertical lines get in there and they're very aging and they're harder to get rid of. So prevention is key. Losing the vermilion border and getting vertical lip lines, and it doesn't mean that you're smoking necessarily. Most people are not smokers who get them, but it's a great reason to get lip filler. Number 6 is the downturn of the mouth. Psychologically, when the mouth turns down, people are unapproachable. They find it that they're less successful, that they don't have the confidence. People approach them differently. So lifting the mouth to a more neutral or even slightly upturned position changes people's lives. That's part of lip filler, because as we lose lateral volume of the lip, and remember, normally the lip tapers to the edge, the mouth wants to turn down. Just adding lip filler to the top lip in near that ergotrid will help raise the edge of the lip, and people love that. They describe wearing less makeup, feeling more confident, and I consider this part of lip filler adding to the oral commissure right at the edge with the droplet technique that I show, helps support the musculature and the fat that's gone, and again, lifts the edge of the mouth. So that is a great reason to get lip filler, to raise the edge of the mouth. Number 7 is symmetry. Now, of course, the Greeks were all focused on symmetry. We're all asymmetric, most of us are, and it's normal and it looks natural. But if there's an asymmetry that people have they don't like, it can be helped along, often not fully changed or improved, nor do we maybe want to be fully symmetric. There's studies on this. But we can get them more towards symmetry by adding lip filler more to one side, and different tricks that we can do just be mindful there's motor asymmetry and there's volume asymmetry. And I'm talking about volume asymmetry. And every time people get lip filler or filler in general, we get them towards more symmetry. But that is a good reason for a great assessment by an injector to see what can be done to obtain symmetry. Number 8 is a wider smile. This started in the 70s and 80s. A wider smile was in. It's in now, but it's not just a wider smile, it's fuller lips with a wider smile. So adding volume laterally. There's many dimensions that go along with this, meaning if the masseters are wider, the lip can be wider. As we're building cheeks, we can go wider with the lip. All kinds of things where we can draw and look for beauty angles. But if you do this a lot and inject product and look at beauty, we naturally are calculating this, but you can measure it. So getting a wider smile, if it's something that you want to do, is a great reason, and lip fillers work very well to create a wide smile. So there's 8 good reasons to get lip filler. Thanks for joining me in this YouTube channel. Join us on Instagram. Subscribe below to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.